I'm Tsubasa Yokomine. This is my sister, Ai. She was 5 years younger than me. I loved her very much.
Tsubasa!
What is it?
As a kid, she was always getting sick. She didn't even go to school until she was in third grade.
Play with me.
Okay.
I always played with her so she wouldn't feel lonely. I always let her watch whatever she wanted.
You ripped my doll's dress!
Mom, buy her a new one. Those things are expensive, though. Could you wait until next month?
We had medical bills to pay, and Mom had to take care of my sister around the clock. So our family wasn't very wealthy.
I know! Why don't we cover it up using tissues? If we use rubber bands, it'll be like a real dress!
Thanks. This will do for now.
No, I'll figure something out. Just give me some time.
The next morning.
Tsubasa, look! Did you make this?
Yup.
Thanks!
I made all kinds of clothes for a doll after that. And the thing is, I was pretty good at this.
Tsubasa, did you take a piece of my apron? Oh, sorry. I ran out of cloth.
This is amazing! You're so good at this! I love you so much!
By the time my sister was in fourth grade, she was feeling much better. She was able to go to school with the other kids. Thank goodness.
I want new clothes for college, but they're way too big for me.
Yeah, you're pretty short.
I know. I want to wear something more mature, but they're all too big.
No worries, I gotcha.
You're so good at this, Tsubasa.
When I was a kid, I realized this was my calling. After high school, I enrolled in fashion school. I won all kinds of awards while I was there. After that, I started working as a designer at a major apparel company. Then when I was 24 and I was 29, she said she wanted to introduce me to her boyfriend.
This Sunday, I'm going to his house to see his parents. Will you come with me? I want you to meet him before I introduce him to Mom and Dad.
Then, a few days later...
Wow, look at this place! They must be loaded!
Hello, I'm Satoshi Tsushima. Nice to meet you.
Hey, and nice to meet you too.
She's told me a lot about you. She speaks very highly of you.
He was 2 years older than her. He looked really nice. He was currently working at his father's company. He was gonna take over as CEO one day. I had a good feeling about him. But then...
You again? Give it up already! You're not marrying my brother! Satoshi, why are you dating her? She's probably poor! You could do so much better!
Arena, Satoshi's sister, didn't seem to like her.
Arena, I said stop it!
But I don't want you marrying her! Look at her! And I heard she's always getting sick. She'll just cause you trouble.
Arena, when she was little, she was going in and out of the hospital, but she's fine now. You got nothing to worry about.
But what if her disease gets passed down to her children?
That's enough!
I won't let you marry her. I won't!
I'm sorry. She's always like this. She's just really worried about me.
I know how she feels.
My parents already said yes, so you don't have to worry.
Okay. So she's always like that, huh?
Yeah. She's just mad that I'm taking her brother away from her. I want to be friends with her, but...
I see. Satoshi seems nice, but I'm not so sure about his sister.
Yeah, but I get it. If you brought someone over to the house and told me you were marrying her, I'd be kinda jealous too, so...
A few weeks later, our parents met up with his. They were all really happy for him. A few days later, they got married. Then they got their own apartment and started preparing for the wedding. But then... I'm gonna miss her, but as long as she's happy. Then, about 6 months later, I left home and got my own place as well. She still texted me every day. I still couldn't believe she was getting married.
Hey, check out my wedding dress. Pretty neat, right?
Oh, nice! Looking good! You got the right size and everything?
Yeah.
can't wait for the wedding. Then, around 2 weeks before the wedding, I got a call from Ai during lunch break.
Tsubasa, maybe I shouldn't get married.
What happened? You crying? Just calm down. I'll meet you at the house.
Hey.
So that wedding dress she got? Arena ruined it. They tried to get it fixed, but there wasn't enough time. So they called me.
This is terrible. How can someone do this?
This is gonna take some work.
I'm so sorry about this. I'll get you a new one.
It's okay. We don't have enough time. I'll just rent one.
I seemed really upset. Can't say that I blame her. How did this happen?
Arena told me she wanted to come over, so I invited her to dinner, but then this happened.
Satoshi, I'll be blunt. I'm worried about this marriage. You gotta do something about Arena.
I know. I'll protect her, I promise.
That's not good enough. I mean, look what happened here. I need more than just your words.
Fine. I'll cut all ties with Arena.
Satoshi called his parents up and told him everything. They came over to the house right away.
We're terribly sorry.
I can't believe she would do this. I'm so sorry.
I'm gonna have a long talk with her at home. She'll never bother you two again. I give you my word.
I'll fix the dress, no worries. I was working as a designer for a famous clothing brand now. Sir, can I use the office at night and on weekends for about 2 weeks? Sure thing! I gotta hurry. I don't have much time!
Wow, is that a wedding dress?
Hey Yuri, what are you doing here so late? One night, one of our models showed up at the office. Her name was Yuri.
Oh, I forgot my stuff here. You're still working?
Well, kind of. My sister, her wedding is in 2 weeks, but her dress got ruined, so I'm trying to fix it.
That's really sweet of you.
I'll do anything for her. When she was born, the doctors gave her 3 years to live. But she worked hard, and now she's all grown up. I just want her to be happy.
She's so lucky to have you.
The next day.
Hey there, I got some food and drinks here.
Thank you. Yuri came to see me every now and then. It was kind of nice.
His work is amazing. I love watching him work.
Yeah, he's an amazing designer. Then, 3 days before the wedding, I was finally finished. It wasn't easy, but I fixed up her dress. Yes! Finally!
Wow. Thank you so much for this.
This is much better than the original. You made all this?
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Then, wedding day. I looked beautiful. Arena, can we talk? She told me she wanted to be friends with you.
I love my brother, and I felt like she was stealing him away from me, and they told me I can't see her anymore. They let me attend the wedding, but...
I get it. I love my sister too, but listen, if you really love your brother, you gotta be happy for him. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Good. We gotta let him go at some point, you and I both.
I'm so sorry. I know saying sorry doesn't make it right, but I'll pay for the dress and all the damages I've caused. I'm truly sorry. I'll never bother you again.
I know how you feel, Arena. I love my brother too, so... Listen, Arena. I've always wanted to be friends with you. I want to go shopping with you and stuff. It's not too late to start.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
So, Tsubasa, you getting married anytime soon? You don't have to worry about me anymore, you know?
I know. Soon.
Okay, hey, thanks for everything, Tsubasa. You're the best brother ever. I love you so much.
My sister, she was all grown up. She's not a kid anymore.
Can you make me a wedding dress?
Huh? Sure, but maybe you should leave it to the professionals?
No. I want to wear it at our wedding someday. Please?
Huh? Okay. 1 year later, Yuri and I got married. She had 3 older brothers. She was the youngest child. She was all over me.
Meow. What kind of dress are you making for me next? Can't wait!
Meow!
So now I was happily married. I'm glad everything worked out.
I'm Riku Kanzaki. I'm a lawyer. 3 months ago, I fell in love. Ugh, I hate running errands from a shoe. Why can't you just do this by yourself? I guess I'm the only one that she can ask. Still!
Move it!
Ugh! What the?
Cockroach!
Crap!
Put a bag over the box! Now!
Oh, right!
No worries, they're just crickets. Please, help us!
I dropped a box filled with crickets in the front lobby. I panicked, but she came out of nowhere and helped me out. It was love at first sight. Thank you so much. How can I ever thank you?
You guys have a pet at your office or something?
Yeah. Our boss has a pet chameleon and I always have to get crickets for it.
Oh, I see. A chameleon, huh? Nice.
You like reptiles as well?
Well, my late grandpa used to work at a pet shop, so I'm used to seeing bags of crickets.
Again, thank you so much!
Oh, don't mention it.
I wanted to take her out for some coffee to thank her, but I didn't see her after that. I really want to see her again.
Kanazaki, I got some information you might be interested in.
Huh? Oh, what is it, Miss Shu?
The girl that helped you the other day. Her name is Fumika Nomori.
What? How did you...
I wanted to thank her too, so I looked her up. She works for the same floor as us, so you might run into her again real soon. So, good for you.
What's that supposed to mean?
You're in love with her, right?
What? How did you...
Cause I'm a really good lawyer. I know everything.
Why? After that, I saw her a few times around the elevator and stuff, but I never really talked to her. Anyways, she was so pretty. Just seeing her made my day brighter. But then, about 6 months later, she started acting all weird. Something was bothering her. She looks exhausted. She's sick or something? I'm worried. But if I say something, she'll realize I've been staring at her for the past 6 months. What if she thinks I'm a stalker or something? I can't have that. I'm an attorney. Then one day, I was working late. Around midnight, I stepped out to get some coffee. But then, on my way out, I ran into her. Oh, hey!
Hi.
Was she crying? Is everything okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
You sure? Looks like there's something on your mind.
I'm fine, really.
If you need help with something, I'm a lawyer. Maybe I can help. I work at the law office across the elevator hall.
I gotta go.
There's something she's not telling me. The next morning, I ran into her at the elevator. There, she handed me a note. What the... That night, I met up with her at the restaurant.
It's my company. Work conditions are horrible. They don't even pay us for OT, but the CEO makes us work around the clock, even on weekends. I can't take it. I thought about quitting, but if I quit now, there are only 4 of us, so I'll just be putting more burden on the other 3.
I see.
You're a lawyer, right? Is there a way to solve this without causing a lot of trouble? Needless to say, I'll pay you by the hour.
My guess is the other 2 feel the same way. They all want to quit, but can't because of the same reason you just mentioned.
Maybe.
Why don't you ask them how they feel first?
Huh?
If you ask me, your CEO is just taking advantage of you. Even if you tell him that you want to quit, he'll think of something to try to make you stay. But if you want to quit, you should. And if your colleagues feel the same way, you should all quit at once. I can certainly help you with that.
Thank you. I'm gonna ask my colleagues right away.
A week later, Nomori and her colleagues came to see me.
We want to quit. Tell us what to do.
Okay. First, you gotta tell them you quit. Don't say, I'm thinking about quitting, Just say, I'm quitting. Then write a letter of resignation. Send him an email as well, just in case he refuses to accept the letter of resignation.
But if we don't quit at once, the business will fall apart. Can he sue us for that?
For quitting? No. He can't sue you for that. If anything, you'll be suing him for unpaid overtime, so you don't have to worry about that.
But even if I hand in a letter of resignation, I still have to go into work, right? What if he tries something on us?
You haven't taken paid leave in a while, right? Just use those. Then you won't have to go into the office. And tell him to go through your lawyer if he wants to talk with you. I'll handle everything from there.
Wow. I had no idea about any of this. He knows everything. He's amazing.
Mr. Kanzaki, thank you so much.
After that, they all became my clients. I helped them quit their job and collect unpaid OT. Then, a few weeks later, it was Fumika's last day at the office.
This is where you dropped that box full of crickets. That takes me back.
Yeah. Oh, that was embarrassing.
At first, I thought you were trying to play a prank on someone, but when I saw your face, I realized it wasn't a prank.
Yeah, I was freaking out. You really helped me out.
So, I guess this is it. I'm glad I was able to quit, but I'm gonna miss this place.
Same here. I'm gonna miss her. I gotta tell her. It's now or never.
Can I take you out to dinner?
What?
Huh?
I'd love to.
Looking forward to it.
A few days later, we went out to dinner. We started dating shortly afterward. To this day, Miss Shu says that she's the one that brought the two of us together. I guess she had a point. I'm Daisuke Momose, a 21-year-old college student. Oh crap, the train's arriving real soon. She's kinda crouching. Probably not feeling well. Is everything alright? Are you feeling unwell?
No. My pumps. I was wondering what to do as the heel snapped.
Is that so? Well, I just bought these new sandals. You could use them if you want to.
Thank you. Then, please, you could have this as my thing.
And shoot, my train's coming! You can keep them. I just snagged them off a dollar store for a dollar anyways. See ya! I was running late for my part-time job back then, and remembering things was the last thing on my mind.
$1?
But after 2 days, only then did I remember what happened. Ah, today's my day off! Watching Sakai no Fushigi while on my couch? Sounds like a plan. What the... What's with these luxury cars parked all the way back there?
Oh, hi there, Momose. Heading home?
Yes. Are you heading out right now, owner?
Why, yes. I'm going to the mall. Maybe shop for a few goods and perhaps grab a lovely dinner there.
That's news to me. What's gotten into you? I remember you saying malls aren't really your kind of thing. You know, being all that fancy and stuff. What made you change your mind?
See, I had a change of heart. Momose, you youngsters ought to drop off that stubborn attitude and try going with the flow. Or else you'd be left behind with times. Well then, if you'll excuse me.
That's something I'd least suspect hearing from her. I wonder what's going on.
Welcome back.
This is probably my room, right? The key fit correctly, so... Who the hell was that? And why are they in my room?
Mr. Daisuke Momose? I owe you a sincere thank you for extending your help 2 days ago. I have been waiting for this opportunity, and it's a pleasure to finally meet you.
You're who? And... Why are you in my room? Oh, 2 days ago, at the station, me, sandals. Right, I do remember those happening. I was in a hurry, so Things are a bit fuzzy now.
You have my utmost gratitude for that day.
Even I am but the humble butler would like...
Hold on a moment. Yes, a butler?
Yes, I am in service of her, Miss Ayano Takasukasa, their personal butler tending to the madam's needs. I am one serving the Takasukasa household for generations.
Takasukasa, was it?
The Takasukasa delves in a wide variety of businesses, from land developments, construction works, and manufacturing equipment, to food enterprises, as well as financial services. All these are under the Takasukasa group.
Huh. Hearing that tells me you're all impressive. But how'd you find out this was my house? I don't remember telling you my name.
Mr. Daisuke, it is all thanks to the dollar store receipt you left inside the sandals bag. Our young miss was in the middle of her practice to get accustomed riding trains all alone as part of her social studies. The Takasukasa household, along with me, was watching Miss Ayano from afar. But the miss did, however, wanted to extend her sincerest gratitudes. And so, we traced the store from your receipt and awaited your return, Mr. Momose. We waited for the mister to return to the shop, from whence we tailed you to this address, helping us discover your identity.
That's just hella creepy!
We're glad to have found your place. However, you weren't inside at the moment, and so we politely asked the landlady if we could wait inside. We, the Takasukasa, presented our sincerest gestures, and she kindly acknowledged them enough to...
Our sincerest gestures? She kindly acknowledged them. Wait a moment. The landlady was strangely in a good mood when she went out, was dressed up and wore heavy makeup. The owner, did she... No, hold up. I own this place, though.
Thank you for presenting your sandals the other day. In return, I ask you to kindly accept these as a token of gratitude.
Even the packaging's quite fancy.
Please accept these. They are sandals from Harms. I'm confident we chose the right ones too.
Harm these sandals? This brand doesn't ring a bell, but I bet these are sold at a ridiculously high price. Oh no. You know those sandals I gave just costed me a dollar, right? I can't possibly accept these. Besides, there was no need to repay for them.
I see. How can I possibly thank you? Would you prefer them in cash, similar to the landlady?
There's no need for that, really. I'm not asking for anything in return.
But still...
Mr. Momose, please allow me to present something further. The young miss seems to have taken a liking to his mister, and as such, would like to get acquainted with you.
With me?
Right, yes. I wasn't so sure to myself, but hearing it now, that might be the case. Little did I know that things purchased through a meager sum of a dollar existed in our world. A shocking yet telling reality. Imagine a world full of wonders I have yet to see. I had no friends until now, but will you do me the honor of becoming one?
She's so innocent and pure. I mean, just look at her overflowing with curiosity. I can't possibly accept your thank you gift. I'll be more than happy to be friends, though.
Yay! Thank you so much!
Her way of sizing up things are a bit sketchy, but she's probably a kind person at heart. And so with that, during my free time, I met up with Ayano, then went to all sorts of places.
There's even a map showing how one can navigate such trains. Everything's complicated. Which one's which? They're all so confusing.
Well, the Metro train stations are chaotic as the routes do crisscross like a mess, so yeah, you'd end up being confused. You'll do fine as long as you remember the local lines for starters. From there, I guess then you'd be adding other transfer routes.
What would you call this dish?
A takoyaki. Careful, they're still hot.
It's hot.
Are you all right? She's flustered. That's kind of cute.
That was hot, but it was very delicious. Surely a dish like this would be considered a luxury, wouldn't it?
Oh, those are 50 cents for 8 pieces.
That can't be. A gourmet dish like this being offered at a measly price. Oh, perhaps the owner isn't aware of how much worth such dishes hold.
Expensive meals would taste real good, no doubt. Well, that's as far as my imagination goes, as I've never tried one. However, delicious food need not to be expensive. You know, people can really be imaginative and creative. You'll never know how they can utilize cheap ingredients to whip up something delicious. That's it! Think you can handle more food? There's a resto I'd really love to show you. How'd that taste? Also, these burgers only sell for a dollar without tax. Kind of amazing, right?
Huh. Is this the famed hamburger I've heard from rumors? A gourmet like this? Even more for a measly dollar?
One could argue that they could price them this low, as this chain store is quite big. Plus, they operate on a large scale. Well, that's one case to make, but putting these earnings into good use? I think the company poured their efforts into making it a success. So yeah, my goal is to join this company after graduation.
Really? I can finally return the favor then!
What'd you mean by that?
Yes. So this chain store is a conglomerate under the Taku Tsukasa group. I could ask my dad to let you join the company somewhat easily.
Oh, please, don't do that.
Huh?
That sounds like forcing myself into a company through connections. And even if I did, it wouldn't just feel the same. Commanding my peers as if I'm looking down on them would really be awkward to others. This company truly values hard work and dedication, which I would want to be a part of. That's why I study real hard. Don't go around tossing a wrench into the works of somebody. Sorry for blurting out. You probably just want what's best for me.
No, I'm terribly sorry.
I made things suddenly awkward, leaving Ayano feeling dejected. After this incident, those messages from an Ayano who's eager to hang out stopped coming. I might have overreacted. Also, my hands were full right now as job hunting's coming real soon. It was not a leisure to worry about Ayano. I grinded my days off all for that sweet job offer. Everything was hectic. Things passed by so quickly. And then, I just landed a job offer!
Congratulations! Now that you've mentioned it, I prepared a surprise for you too.
A surprise? Meet our new hires this season. Congratulations! And on behalf of all the members, welcome aboard!
Huh?
Why are you here?
Well, I did say surprise, right? But I'm not here because of my father. That story you shared with me during our dinner, it really touched my heart. And so, since then, I've been focusing on my studies. I worked hard finding a job and landed an offer on my own.
So earlier, that Sakatsutaka, was it?
I've heard that people use pseudonyms, a professional alias for business. And so only a few people here know my true name. So, I've been thinking, after we'd lost touch for some time, you left a huge impression on me, Daisuke.
Ayano. Well, same here.
Really?
There might have been twists and turns along the way, but our relationship ultimately progressed to being that of a couple. If you're really trying to hide the fact that you're a Takasukasa, dropping off that formal tone's probably a good idea.
Oh, okay, so, Mr. Daisuke, Daisuke, could we live together and help me polish my skills every day?
What? We might still be too early for that. Nobody knows that Ayano was this young miss from the Takasukasa household, besides me.
I'm Koki Sadoka. I'm a 20-year-old college student. I had a crush on this girl. Hey!
Hey, it's Sadoka! Right on time as always!
Hey, man. Where is she? Ah, there she is.
Hey, how was yesterday? I got some good shots myself.
It was okay, I guess. Her name was Madoka Sato. We were both in the photography club. She was the quiet type and she kept to herself, but that's what I liked about her. We only made small talk, but I wanted to know more about her. But how?
Okay then, let's begin, shall we? Come on, take your seats.
I joined the photography club when I was a freshman here. A few years back.
What the? Semi-photography club? What does that mean?
Hey, are you a freshman? You want to join us? I'm Sato. I'm the club president. Nice to meet you.
Okay. It was a club for people who liked photography, but we used smartphones and stuff instead of real cameras to take pictures. That's why they call it the semi-photography club. I see. It was a perfect club for me. We were just there to have fun. We took pictures of things we liked and showed it to each other. That was pretty much it. There were a lot of Satos in our club. It was a pretty common last name, but still. Some of the kids at school called us the Sato Club.
Okay then. We'll be using Madoka's picture of a cat on our website for the week. Any objections?
No!
Okay then. Let's decide on where to go for our next photo shoot. Any requests?
Photo shoot! This might be a good opportunity to become friends with Madoka.
Hey, I'm here! Am I too late?
No, we were just about to vote on where to go for our next photo shoot.
Ah, okay. Is Yuto here? No? Oh, okay then. I gotta go. Bye!
Hey, Nori! She does this all the time!
Forget her. She's just here for Yuto. She pays her monthly fee, so whatever.
I haven't seen Yuto in a while, though. I've only seen him, like, once.
Yuto, he's the most popular kid in campus. I've only seen him a few times, though. I wish I was like him, then I'd get more girls.
Hey, Sadooka. Are you going to the party this weekend?
Huh? Yeah.
Oh, okay. I guess I'll go too, then.
Yeah, it'll be fun. More the merrier. Wait, maybe she likes me or something. Nah, can't be. At the party. Some clubs on campus, all they did was party. Our club president didn't like to drink though, so we didn't have that many parties at a club. But some of us still went out for drinks every now and then. Madoka usually didn't come to these things, but...
Oh, I can't believe she's here! This is gonna be fun!
But then, something unexpected happened.
Yuto? He's here too?
He never shows up to anything, though. Well, it's been a while since I saw him. Hey, Nari was there, too. She was all over Yuto. She's so close to him.
Yuto, you're so handsome. What's your secret? You should join us more often. The photography class would be so much more fun if you were there. You gotta come.
You're never there, either.
As you already know, everyone in the club looks pretty lame. They make me stand out, so I can't complain. But still...
What the hell is the problem?
She's so desperate, it's pathetic.
We were getting pretty annoyed by her, but nobody tried to stop her. Why? Because her family was super rich. They made large amounts of donations to the school. Not sure how much, but I heard it was a lot of money. She couldn't really say anything to her. She just had too much power over us.
Like, look at Sadooka. He's so ugly. I mean, look at his face.
Oh, here we go again. She's always doing hits. I know I'm not that good looking, but why say it out loud?
So you admit it, huh? Well, good. I feel bad for people like you, though. Good looking people belong together. Right, Yuto?
You're gonna let her talk to you like this? Well, it's annoying, but it's true, so...
I don't think you're ugly, Sadooka.
Madoka?
Huh? She's defending you now? Pathetic. Well, she's pretty ugly too, so... You two would make a great couple!
Hey! You can say whatever you want about me, but leave her out of this!
Oh, wow. Are you yelling at me? Chill out.
Madoka isn't ugly! She's super hot, are you blind? Look at her!
Her? Pretty?
That's a good one. I think you're the one that's blind. Hey, Madoka, you hear that? Don't start blushing now. Look at you two. Two ugly people standing up for each other. It's so pathetic.
Well said, Sadoka. I've never seen you so angry before. You like her?
What? Yeah. Wait, what did I just say?
You hear that, Madoka? Congrats.
Stop it, Yuto.
Huh? Wait, they know each other?
What was your name, Mika? Listen, the thing is, Doka, she's my sister.
What? Sister? What? For real?
Yeah, she's my little sister.
What? They're related?
Not sure if you knew that, but how dare you talk to my sister like that?
I didn't know. I didn't mean it like that. I was just kidding.
But you called her ugly.
What? No, I didn't. I was just messing around.
Didn't sound like it.
I...
Idiot. Stop trying to deny it. Let's get one thing clear. Madoka is pretty, much prettier than you. And you think your family is rich? Think again. Ask your daddy about SZK Solutions. That's my father's company.
I'm sorry.
You say thank you. She told me about you. I wanted to see you in person, so I decided to join.
I told you not to come.
I had no idea you two were related. Yeah, we got a lot of Satos in our club, so... He's a really nice guy once you get to know him. Alright, I'm gonna go now. Walk her home, will you? Of course.
Sorry about this. I was gonna tell you about him.
Oh, it's fine.
Right, around middle school, the boys in class started hitting on me, and it was really annoying. So I put on glasses and didn't wear makeup to keep them away, but I guess there's no need for that now.
Oh, I see. But why me?
When we were freshmen, you helped me out at the station when I lost my train card, remember? You're a sweet guy. I've always liked you.
I remember that at all. Oh, I guess she remembered me, and she's had a crush on me ever since. Kenari stopped being a jerk after that. Peace returned to the photography club. And now I had a girlfriend. Life is good.
Oh, good morning.
Hey, are you going to classes? Good luck.
Thanks. How can she be so pretty all the time? My name is Eito Sakuragi. I'm 20 and a sophomore in college. I come from a single-parent household. I used to live happily with my father and my younger sister. However, my father passed away in an accident last week. It hasn't hit me yet since it was so sudden.
Daddy, why did you have to leave us?
Nana, I'm here for you. It's gonna be okay, I promise.
But how are we going to live now that Daddy is gone?
My little sister Nana is still 13 years old. We don't have a mother. Our parents got a divorce when Nana was 6. And our mother left us with our father. We haven't met or seen her once since the divorce. Look at me. I'm right here. Don't worry about it. I've always been here when you needed me. And that's not gonna change. Ever. I quit college yesterday. I'll start working. And we'll get through this.
I'm so sorry, Eito. I know how hard you studied to get into college. But do all the homework from now on so you can focus on your work.
My father was an only child. And our grandparents have passed away. We don't have any relatives either. Nana and I only had each other to rely on. Gosh, I'm 20 with only a high school diploma. Plus, I can't leave my 13-year-old sister at home alone at night. I don't think there are going to be many jobs to pick from. I need to keep the money Dad left for us so I can pay Nana's school fees. I can't waste any of it. I should start working part-time while I find a full-time job. Gosh, I'm tired. Maybe I should lie down for a bit. I open the door to find my neighbor standing outside. Her name is Kokonoe-san, and she's been living next to us for many years. We don't talk much, but we say hi in the hallways whenever we bump into each other.
I heard that your father passed away last month.
Yes, in an accident.
I'm so sorry. I didn't know. I just found out today. I'm sure your father is worried about leaving you two behind.
We'll be okay. I'm 20. I'm not a kid anymore.
Oh, I'm sorry if that offended you. You're looking after your sister on your own, right? I respect you for it, but you look so tired. Are you okay?
I'm just tired because I work from early morning to early evening. I don't want to leave my sister alone because it hasn't been long since my father passed away. I'm trying to find a full-time job, but it hasn't been easy since I can only offer limited time to work.
You are such a caring brother. Your sister is in middle school, 7th grade if I remember, right? You know, I work from home. I can watch over your little sister until you come back from work. That way, you'll have more options to pick from, right?
I appreciated her offer, but I didn't know her enough to ask for such a favor. I didn't know what to say. Oh, but...
How about you bring your sister and we can have dinner together? I promise, I'm not a creep with ulterior motives.
I didn't mean it that way.
I'll see you at 7. I hope you like my cooking.
Hey, Nana, do you remember our neighbor? The woman next door?
Yeah, the pretty lady, right? She smells so good every time I pass her on the stairs. I wonder what perfume she uses. She's so cool.
She wants us to go over to her place for dinner tonight.
What? I would love to. I've always wanted to talk to her.
Nana and I rang Miss Kakonoe's doorbell, and she greeted us with a bright smile. My heart was pounding. This was the first time I'd ever been inside a girl's room. This is for you.
Oh, you didn't have to. I love fruit, so this is perfect. Thank you. You know, I never got to ask you your name. My name is Hajime.
I'm Nana. Nana Sakuragi. And my brother's name is Eito.
It was weird introducing ourselves to somebody we've known for so long. The lady's name was Hajime, and she told us she was 25 years old.
Nana, can you turn on the hot plate for me? I haven't done yakiniku in such a long time. Living alone is lonelier than you think.
Well, we haven't had yakiniku ever since our father passed away.
It would be nice if the three of us could get together from time to time to eat together like this.
Hajime, did you make the designs on the snack box?
I did. This is what I do for work. Nana, you might have seen this one in stores.
Everybody has lip gloss. You designed this too? Oh, my friends love this. They think the bottle is cute.
I'm glad they like it. You know, they gave me all the colors. You could take ones that you like.
No, for real?
Nana, she never asked me to buy anything because she knows we don't have any money to spare. Nana hit it off with Hajime immediately. She seemed to be having more fun than when she was with me. Why did you decide to work from home?
Well, I have some medical condition. It started when I was working at my previous company. I was lucky to have a kind boss. He suggested I work from home as a contract employee. So, Nana, you can come over whenever your brother can't come home early from work.
Huh? Really?
Yes, I would love to get to know you better. We should hang out so neither of us is lonely.
Thank you! You know that you're having trouble finding a job because of me. But it was so scary thinking about spending that time alone at home after everything.
Nana!
Hajime, you don't know how much this means to me. I'll help you do the housework in return.
I was relieved to see that Nana became livelier after connecting with Hajime. Shortly after, a nearby factory hired me as a full-time employee. They pay well, and the working conditions are great. Everyone is so kind and welcoming. I owe you big, Hajime.
Great! We should celebrate tonight!
Oh, hey! You don't have to do that! If you hadn't noticed, I had fallen in love with Hajime. She is beautiful and successful, and I couldn't help my feelings, even though I knew she was too good for me.
We're having tamaki sushi today. Nana, help me cut the sashimi. I haven't had sushi in so long.
Even if I couldn't tell her how I felt, it was enough for me to have her near like this. 3 months passed after I started working at the factory. Eating dinner together had become part of our daily routine. One of the things I looked forward to was buying Hajime and Nana cake on my payday. I wish there was something more I could do to repay her for her kindness. She'll only accept money for the food.
This is too much.
You take care of Nana, and I want to pay for some of your utility bills.
You don't need to pay me unnecessary money. Friendships like this never last when money becomes an issue, okay?
One day, at the beginning of winter...
Hey, Eito! Your little sister's on the phone. You better get there fast. Sounds like an emergency.
Huh? Nana? Okay, thank you, sir.
Eito, help! I think Hajime is unconscious.
Okay, calm down. You just need to call an ambulance. Stay with her until you get to the hospital.
Is something wrong? You can leave early if you need to.
Thanks, boss. I promise to make it up to you.
I'm so sorry. I caused you so much trouble. I kept imagining what would happen if you never woke up. Oh, don't cry. I feel awful.
The nurse told us. Hajime, you don't have any family?
Yeah, you saved my life, Nana. It means so much to have you two with me right now.
That day, I went home and thought about it through the night. Maybe we weren't the only ones who needed somebody.
Eito, Hajime told me she's coming home tomorrow. It's a Saturday. Can you come with me to pick her up?
Of course, I'll be there. Will you marry me, Hajime? I know, I'm not wealthy, but I'll do everything in my power to give you the life you deserve. I want to be by your side.
Eito, have you forgotten I'm 5 years older than you?
I don't care! You are the kindest, most beautiful woman in the world!
You're silly. You're only saying that because you haven't been overseas. You should see the beauties out there.
So, are you saying no? I know I'm not the most attractive guy. I'm short, I didn't go to college, and I work in a factory. But I promise to buy you a cake on my payday every month. You can keep all the money I make. I can live off a 500 yen allowance every day. And I promise to take care of you no matter what!
Okay, I think I'm gonna say yes. Who can say no to cake? Wait, Hajime, you're gonna marry my brother? Yep, I'd love nothing more than to become a real family with you. Are you sure? He's so short, plus his feet smell, and sometimes he goes to bed without brushing his teeth.
Nana, shut up!
Don't worry. I'm designing the packages for toothpaste and shoe deodorizers. The companies usually send me samples. But he's so short. It's okay.
Meh. 2 years later, the three of us are still happily living together. I'm home! Who wants some cake? My name's Mizuki Sawabe, a college freshman. I've been going out with my girlfriend for almost a year. However, happy birthday, Hana. Here, a present.
What's this?
I got you a whale-shaped humidifier, but wasn't too sure if you'd like this.
Huh, yeah. Yeah, this one's a no. A birthday just doesn't feel right without a restaurant reservation. Being cooped up in a house for a date's really boring. Then, there's this. You even got me the wrong gift. Mizuki, you could be tasteless when it comes to things like this, huh? I'd suggest going for the usual, like buying luxury brand accessories, right?
Well, I called you over as I prepared some handmade cakes. I remember you saying you want to try those luscious cakes the other time, so...
Handmade cakes? No, you got me all wrong. How about treating me to a gourmet cake? You know, real luscious, made by a pro? I'll be frank, Mizuki. I've always thought you were no-go from the get-go. If things went well during my birthday celebration, I'd give you a second thought. But as you see, we're not a match. Yeah, we're breaking up.
Huh? Wait. From the start? You already thought of breaking up with me?
Yep. Turns out, dating a working boyfriend was the right choice. He even has a car, money.
Why do this? I'll be graduating in 2 years. And about the money? Surely I earn more by that time, so just why?
Oh, sure. I wonder if that's the case. If you do earn, though, there's still this issue. You've got such poor taste. Good luck fixing that.
That's just... So that's how this story, which happened 2 weeks ago, went. With her rejecting me. I stopped going to my part-time job because it was the sole reason I wanted money. For dates with her, the gifts I gave her, I spent each day in a daze until I received a sudden call from my aunt.
Oh, Mizuki, sorry to bother you, but I would like to ask you a favor. Could you look out for my cat while staying here for a month?
Are you going somewhere, Aunt Rumiko?
My work needs me on an overseas trip for a month. I originally thought of boarding her to a pet hotel, but I feel awfully bad leaving her there for a month.
Aunt Rumiko is my mom's sister. There's a big age gap between her and mom. She's just 32 years old, even currently working as a model. It seems like people like her, who work in that industry, kind of live a luxurious life. Ever since then, Aunt even got me some fancy souvenirs. Rumiko's that cool aunt I was real proud of. Plus, we're on good terms since I was little. Sure, my college is not that far from your place, so I'll do it.
And, oh, I won't really mind if you bring your female friends here.
Knock that off, Auntie. My girlfriend just rejected me.
Oh, is that so? How about going for a blind date with me tagging along? A college student living here in a condominium? You'd be popular.
Nah, lying and deceiving people's not really my thing. And thus, that day marked the beginning of my round trip past my college, then condominium life.
Huh? Isn't that Mizuki? What is he doing in a high-rise luxury condo like this? He normally lives in this condo? Or did he just start dating someone who lives here? What is happening?
All right, fine. Let's grab you a meal first. Besides, this room is still a mess. Might as well clean him up as I'll be living here for a while. Ugh! She did have a robot vacuum. It was just buried underneath this mess. The floor is littered with so many things, this poor thing can't even move an inch. Hey! Just found one more here! There! She does have three vacuums, though they're all completely broken. Aunt Rumiko surely wanted to clean her room, but realized she wasn't up to the task. And so, as a result, employed the help of three robot vacuums. It still needed at least clean or tidy things aside, so assigning the cleaning tasks to the robots? I'd imagine that was a total disaster. What a waste of money, really. Huh? Hello?
Mizuki, I have a favor to ask. My friend should be coming there for the souvenirs I bought. However, that slipped out of my mind. She's at the station already. Could you fetch her?
What? Why?
I'll be owing you a lot, really. I already told her it was my fault this happened, and you'd be going to fetch her. And maybe prepare tier two too.
Gotcha. Make sure to tell her about me, okay? Whew. Cleaning the room was the right idea. After that, Aunt Rumiko sent me a picture of her friend. I searched across the station using the pic as reference to easily spot her. Wow, she's really pretty! That's Aunt Rumiko's friend for ya!
Excuse me, are you Mizuki?
It's her. Her real deal's right in front of my eyes!
I'm Rumiko Jr., Sayumi. Sorry for coming on a whim while Rumiko was out. I kinda didn't know she was going abroad.
No worries. It's Aunt Rumiko who should be apologizing, as she'd forgotten to tell you that. Hope I didn't make things awkward with me fetching you instead of Aunt Rumiko. Aunt says to make you feel at home, so being alone with a real cute girl in that room, this is gonna be awkward.
I'll take you up on that offer. Besides, I wanted to meet her cat for a very long time.
Sure thing. Should we get going then?
Look, isn't that Mizuki over there?
Huh?
That pretty woman beside him is his girlfriend?
No way!
Whoa. So, as it turns out, Mizuki was that rich guy next door in a fancy condo all along. Man, that's a surprise.
Yep. Did you know his relative's a model? If you ask me, they probably got acquainted through other peeps in the same scene.
You're saying that that hottie he just met now is a model too? Jeez, I wish I was him.
Rumiko's room is cleaner than I imagined. I'll be tending to the cats and live here for a month. Well, she didn't say anything about this. Best I tidy up the room first.
Seems like you're really good with organizing and tidying up things. I would really love if you could do the same with my room. Wanna check it out? Oh, you really thought I was for real? Imagine leaving things here as they are and bringing you home. I'd probably get a scolding from her.
That was a joke! She startled me for a sec. Sayumi's a really pretty girl, and I never thought someone like her could be friendly and candid. Getting used to talking with her was something that came naturally. Then I accompanied her up to the station. Today's urgent quest, clear!
Yo, dude! I saw you tagging along with that hottie from yesterday, up to your condo!
Huh? You saw what?
Jeez, I envy this jerk.
You guys aren't snooping, taking pictures, right? And don't go around starting any crazy rumors, too. Those rumors start flying around, Aunt Rimiko's gonna hang me upside down from the condo!
Mum's the word. Selling a friend out will be the last thing this friend's gonna do.
That's what friends are for! Your secret's safe with us, my man!
Mizuki, could you come here for a bit? I want to talk about something.
About what? We can discuss that here.
But saying this out loud might be awkward. I need to talk about this in private.
Dude, is that... Are you thinking about getting back with Mizuki?
Bingo! But you were the one who dumped him, Hana.
My guess is Hana saw Mizuki walking with a pretty hot girl. And so if a hottie hits it off with a man like Mizuki, the man's now worth real something, eh? Yeah, but that's just my two cents.
No, you got it all wrong. I just felt sorry for Mizuki after rejecting him as he looked gloomy. Mizuki really cares, I thought. So, no, I'm here to patch things up with...
No. Nope. Nah. Nada.
You're delusional. He's now dating a real knockout. What makes you think he's gonna grovel back to you? See what I'm trying to say?
Righto! Plus, it was your own decision to dump him in exchange for them working earning dudes.
Nah, I'm a pass, right? I feel better than ever. Don't worry about me. She ain't even my girlfriend. I'm just gonna ride along with her narrative. Anna was still far from over, though. She asked for us to get back on numerous occasions.
Mizuki, it was all my fault. I'm really sorry, so could we forget about all of it?
How are things going with your working boyfriend? I remember you mentioning he was the far better choice, was it?
He was a real jerk, saying he prefers young, dumb girls as they were no strings attached. Just in for a good time. He played me for a fool countless times. This rich guy was sketchy as hell. I even lent him money, and yet...
Hana, you were the one who chose to be with those jerks. And hey, remember? You're still not off the hook for that one. You cheated on me with him.
Where did that caring Mizuki I dated before go? Don't you have any lingering feelings for me?
That caring Mizuki you're talking about? He's now long gone after rejecting him. I'm not the same me when we dated back then. Just don't talk to me. A month had passed, and true to her word, Aunt Rimiko was back here safe and sound.
I'm back! Oh, I really missed you! Oh, where's my manners? Thank you too, Mizuki.
Ha, I'm good.
And, oh, why is my room spick and span?
Sorry. I went ahead and cleaned things up without asking you.
Were you this good at doing household chores?
Yeah, I could say I'm pretty confident when it comes to these.
Cleaning my place 2 times a week as a part-time job. How's this sound? With a room that's this tidy, I could even hold a party with the other girls, right? And, then Mizuki could whip some recipes and even bake a cake with everyone. Won't you pretty please?
Huh. I'm not sure if you should be asking me. Isn't it better to order cakes from a shop?
Oh, Mizuki, the girls would love any dish if it's from a cutie like you.
After that, Aunt Rimiko got carried away with that story and some home parties became a somehow regular thing she'd invite me to. I often visited her house and spent my days being surrounded by gorgeous models.
Mizuki, it's been ages.
Long time no see, Sayumi.
Everybody seems to be getting along with you. Thought I was the only one getting along with you. What a bummer.
That's not true. You're the only one I could easily talk to, I guess.
That's sweet. You say the nicest things. Wow, this is cute. Where did you get them, Rumiko?
Ah, quite the backstory. So Mizuki originally intended to surprise his now ex with this on her birthday. Turns out it was lame. Then he got turned down pretty harshly and ta-da, here it is! It would just go to the trash bin. Really, I did him a favor.
Hey, Aunt Rumiko! It was supposed to be between us!
Why, it's just too adorable! God, I'd be all smiles if someone was to give me this! Can I post this on social media? Like, I spotted this oh-so-adorbs humidifier. Sounds good?
Oh, me too, me too!
Thanks to these hot models' influence on social media, this thing, a gift originally meant as a gift for my ex, got trending in no time. After seeing an article on how it got viral, I can't help but wonder if that certain someone's now stressed. So moving on, after Sayumi and I swapped numbers, we frequently hung out, which did eventually result to this. I'm currently dating her! Every day is just pure bliss!
Thank you for watching all the way to the end. Make sure to subscribe and click the bell for notifications.